Welcome to Woggle Guides. In this guide, we'll look at how to create and share a group calendar for a team in Google Calendar. And don't forget, you can click on any section below to go straight to the area of this guide that interests you. And please do subscribe if you like what you see to be notified when new guides are published. Let's start with a quick look at Google Calendar. All Google users have access to a free calendar that they can use to track and schedule events. It's a powerful tool to help you organize your day-to-day life. Once logged into your Google account, your Google Calendar can be found at the link shown on the screen. This link is also available in the description below. We'll look firstly at how to create a group calendar in Google Calendar. I'm going to demonstrate how to set up a holiday calendar for the Woggle Spy Network. It is a secret though, so don't tell anyone. First step in setting up a group calendar is just to set up a calendar in the usual way. To do this, we start by clicking on the plus sign next to the other calendar's title. From the options shown, let's select Create New Calendar. On this page, let's give the calendar a name. This is the name that will be displayed to anyone with access to the calendar. In addition, we can also add an optional description for the calendar. And you can amend the time zone for the calendar. By default, the time zone will be set as your current time. Once you're happy with the calendar details, click the Create Calendar button, and Google confirms that the calendar has been successfully created. Let's return to the calendar view by clicking on the back arrow. The holiday calendar is then added to the list of My Calendars in the left-hand menu. Let's now take a look at how to share our holiday calendar with other people. To do that, let's go into the holiday calendar settings. We'll do this by hovering over the calendar name, and you'll see three dots appear to the right of the calendar. Let's click on this to see more options. And let's choose to go into the settings and sharing option. On the calendar settings page, move down to the share with specific people section. And let's click on the Add People link. You can add multiple people to a calendar and also choose what levels of access that group can have. There are four levels of access available. See only free busy calendar information. This only shows if a time slot is free or available. See all event calendar details. This includes event detail and timings as well as names of attendees. Make changes to events. This supports scheduling new events and rescheduling or deleting existing ones. Make changes and manage sharing. This is full access to the calendar and includes the ability to change any aspect of it or even delete the calendar. As I want to create a holiday calendar, I'll set the access for all users to be able to make changes to events so they can schedule their holidays directly into the calendar. Once you're happy with the sharing list, click Send to send the notification of calendar access to the invitees. Let's return to the calendar view by clicking on the back arrow. Let's now turn to look at how the invitees accept the invite to the calendar. Each person added to the calendar will receive an email in their inbox confirming that a calendar has been set up and inviting them to add the calendar to their Google Calendar. They can do this by clicking on the Add Calendar link. The link will take them to their Google Calendar and they will be presented with a message box which asks them to confirm they wish to add the calendar. To add the new calendar, click the Add button. And you'll see the holiday calendar has been added to this user's other calendar section in the left-hand menu. I hope you found this Woggle guide useful. If you have, please like or subscribe so that other users can find it too. Thanks for watching, and do look after yourself until next time.